Bon, Nelly Furtado avec nous. Et donc, ouais, ce morceau, on le ressent d'ailleurs quand on voit les images, quand on entend le morceau. Il y a un côté un peu sexy, il y a un petit côté chaud sur ce morceau.
Yeah, it is. It's a sexy song. Probably my sexiest song in my repertoire, I would say. I've got, you know, probably 40 or 50 songs. And Promiscuous is my debut of my more sensual side, I guess. I guess in the video, at least, you see sort of another side of me. You know, I guess I'm growing up in the spotlight, you know. I entered into the music business when I was 19, 20, you know. And now I'm 27. I feel more like a woman. I'm a mother. I feel more feminine. I'm more in control of everything in my life.
C'est quoi le déclic d'un seul coup? Parce qu'on a deux albums où c'est vrai que l'image est travaillée d'une façon un petit peu propre, une gentille jeune fille qui chante de la pop. Et là, d'un seul coup, on bascule, même toi, au niveau physiquement et tout. Je trouve que sur les photos, sur le visuel, il y a eu un changement radical.
It's a combination of things. I think just age, I guess, getting older, and also motherhood. Like from the moment I had my daughter, I just felt like, I don't know, just more mature. And also Miami. Miami's the third component in the equation. And if you see, I have palm trees on the cover of my album because this album is Miami, like to me. I was there for a year off and on. The album was about 4 months. And from the moment I laid the first track down with Timbaland, I knew it was it. I knew that we were going to do this album that was going to be hot. And Miami's a sexy city. It's very liberated. I feel very free when I'm there. I felt like I was on vacation. And also, as a Latin woman in Miami, being able to speak Spanish and Portuguese every day and feeling very at home, feeling amongst other Hispanic American people, just feeling like comfortable in my own skin, I think led to that rawness on the album, honestly.
Regarde justement Miami, il y a les yeux d'un seul coup qui se retournent de son poteau. Et quand on parle de Miami, il y a les yeux qui pétillent d'un seul coup.
Oh, Miami, can you check? Outside of Toronto, you know, Miami is the dime piece capital of the world. You know, 10s and 11s, beautiful women everywhere. And you know, every time I get out
in
to
bikinis,
Miami, in bikinis,
on the main streets,
you know, in the bar, you know, you can take your liquor right onto the street. I mean, that's my kind of life.
Et justement, tu nous en parlais à l'instant, il y a quand même un personnage qui est incontournable sur cet album. C'est l'un des plus gros producteurs. C'est lui qui avait révélé musicalement Alia, qui vient de bosser dernièrement sur l'album de Justin Timberlake et sur l'album de Nelly Furtado. C'est Timbaland. On peut pas parler de cet album sans parler de Timbaland.
You know, Tim's like a force. He's a genius. He's a magical person. I think he's been incredibly gifted by God. He's ferocious with rhythm. You know, nobody really that I've met possesses the same ability to, you know, he becomes the rhythm when he's making a beat. He just becomes it. I mean, 6 years ago we met because he bought my first CD and he wanted to sample it and he loved it. And then he invited me on the Get Your Freak On remix with Missy Elliott, and I did that. And, you know, we always wanted to do an album together, but I guess it wasn't the right timing or something. And finally, by chance, like, I flew to Miami to do one song with him. First day in the studio, we had the beat going for Maneater, which at that time was just basically the da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na- inside of me, like unlike anything I'd felt before while I was making music. Before we knew it, we smelled smoke and we looked at the speaker and it actually caught fire and a flame came out of the speaker. And that was within hours of working on this new album, Loose. And it was a strange moment. We put the music away and worked on a different song even because it kind of freaked us out. So, I don't know. I just love him to death.
D'ailleurs, il y a une citation que j'ai pu lire quelque part où elle dit, voilà, Timbaland, c'est comme de l'amour au plan musical. Tout ce qu'il me fait écouter m'inspire et j'ai envie de chanter sur tout ce qu'il compose. C'est une déclaration d'amour, ça, Timbaland, non?
Yeah, it is like love between us. It is. It's like musical love. It's like, it feels like this crazy, like destined, like musical love between us. And from the second I met him, I actually ran into the vocal booth. Because he played something and I basically it was like, hi, how are you? And I like ran and sang, ah, like what, over whatever beat he was playing.
Deuxième live de l'émission, deuxième live dans Planet Rap, un morceau qui est un peu plus ambiance reggaeton. Le morceau s'appelle No I Igual.
Yeah, perfect.
Is it correct?
Yeah, fake.
No I Igual.
Yeah, oui.
Ouais, et ben c'est maintenant dans Planet Rap.
Yeah. Take a chance and sing me the jingle.
Tu sonido.